bear.
It is I, Sir Cadogan, slayer of Wyvern of Wye.
Revenue.
Call upon Sir Cadogan if you ever require it.
Oh, there it is. Oops.
Got it.
Professor Weasley?
Oh.
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Mm.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard. I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
After you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on those chairs. Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on. Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. I can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Keep it down. Some of us are trying to rest.
I hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
an intruder! Stop them! No, not... that's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
Prepare!
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here? What was that? Was that a golden snitch?
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
Yeah, that's...
Whoops, wrong one. Wait a minute, I'm going the wrong way.
I hope that house elf can find us in here.
We'll come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke. We've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped for the Seeker's needs. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most happen upon it by accident, if ever. Deke's seen students in need of an extra file for potions stumble upon the room filled with them. You seem to have accessed it in its form as the Room of Hidden Things.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically is a place where I can catch up on my schoolwork without distraction.
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Given yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed.
Excuse me.
You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
That one.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes. The magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain resources by vanishing something I've already conjured?
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class. Well done. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Deke will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room.
I'm ready for the next lesson, Professor.
Very well. First, you'll need to gather some moonstone. You can acquire it by vanishing items here in the Room of Requirement, or you can gather it carefully outside of the Hogwarts grounds. Return to me once you've gathered enough, and we shall begin the lesson.
Ah, wrong one. Oops.
Wingardium Leviosa. It can be used to levitate objects for a short time.
Once you've completed a few prerequisite tasks, do see me after class.
Do you have the Moonstone? You can acquire some by vanishing items here in the room, or you can gather it outside the Hogwarts grounds.
I have the Moonstone you requested, Professor.
Good. Then we may begin your lesson. You can conjure more than potions and herbology tables. Conjuration can be used to decorate this space to your liking. Why don't you try it on the walls and floor? Good work. Shall we move on?
I've conjured everything I can. What's next, Professor?
I think you're ready to take on Alteration. The altering spell will allow you to customize any conjured item. You can change the colors, patterns, and styles of your furniture to suit your taste. Let's get started, shall we? Watch closely as I demonstrate how to perform the altering spell.
That's good.
Just aim your wand at any conjured item and perform the altering spell to customize it.
Oops.
Nicely done. Now you're ready for something a little more advanced. You can use the altering spell directly on the room's architecture. Try these new designs on the floor or balcony. Try aiming at the floor or at that balcony whilst using the altering spell.
to death.
Your space might benefit from a bit of ambiance, don't you think? Deke, would you mind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. Professor Weasley showed Deke this bit of magic some years ago. Deke thinks you'll enjoy it. Come and talk to Deke when you're ready.
No problem.
Professor Weasley said I should ask you about changing the room's ambiance.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to feel natural and earthy, as though I'm outdoors.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Quite a difference. Of course, you needn't keep this style if you don't like it. You can always ask Deke to change it back. Now you have learnt a good bit about alteration.
Thank you, Professor. The room is full of possibilities.
Indeed. No matter how much time I spend here, the room always manages to surprise me. Space.
How did that happen?
The room equips itself to your needs. It must have sensed that you needed more space to practice spellcasting. If you'd like to customize the space further, you can use these spellcrafts. You'll find more of them both inside and outside the school.
Thank you, Professor. I shall keep an eye out.
Good. I'll leave you to it. This is your space now. Use it wisely.
Revelio. Welcome to Upper Hogsfield. Charming.
What do you have in store for me this time? Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Come on inside. Oh, watch yourself, though. Let's have you leave here alive.
Lumos.
Such a wee bairn gieing a thrash into a troll. Oh, I can't believe it. Watch yourself, though. Let's have you leave here alive. You followed a wee butterfly to a grand treasure, eh? Sorry, I'm in a bit of a tizzy. I was just scolding some of the plants for spitting and nipping. I suppose it's my own fault for putting more than four to a tray. By the way, Beatrice Green is the name, but you may address me as Madam Green. Welcome to Dogweed and Deathcap. Oh, mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there wasn't the constant demand for antidotes, I wouldn't need to stalk so many of the little dears. Except, of course, for curses. And, well, if you've been petrified, then obviously you've come to the right place. Mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Or if there's an uprooting, you'll be the next one to drop dead, and I'm in no mood for a clear-up.
Someone died here.
Aye. Fortunate, really, that it was just the one. Now then, how may I help you today?
I think I'll just have a look around for now.
Very well. Let me know if you see anything you like.
What do you have for sale?
Well, what say we show you some of what's available? Oh, I'm always thrilled when a young one makes a wise purchase. I can tell you'll go far.
Meh.
Your things will be safe with me, till they're sold. Then you'll have to make do with money. Oh, I'm always thrilled when a young one makes a wise purchase. You'll go far. Well, what say we show you some of what's available? door's always open. You be sure to stop by soon.
This place has seen better days.
Loyalists are a menace. What can be done?
I couldn't help it over here. Did you mention Ranrock's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrock and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolf dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. Simply at my wit's end.
I am unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrock's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury, or worse. Please be cautious. We should not have to live in fear. This is our home. Beyond our borders, Ranrock's loyalists have taken hold here.
I wouldn't mind talking
about that. Bardolf Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by Doc.
Excuse me, did you say something about a Bardolf Beaumont?
I did. I don't think we've met. I'm Dorothy Sprottle. I was just worrying about Claire Beaumont's brother Bardolf. Only he's gone missing. Rumor is he was seen in the forest practicing dark magic. Saw him myself near some ruins with Rookwood's lot I did. I fear he got himself into trouble with the Ashwinders, especially if he made them a promise he couldn't keep. I'd help search for him myself, but no one will risk encountering Ranrock's loyalists. They seem to be everywhere.
I can certainly look out for him.
Any help would be appreciated. You might speak to Claire first. Perhaps she has some insights that I don't. I can tell you that Bardolf was last seen in the forest wearing a particular woolen jumper, one that Claire knitted herself. Claire will be at her shop if you'd like to speak with her.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Revelio!
Thank you.
Madame Beaumont, might I speak with you?
Yes? What about?
Mrs. Sprottle told me a little about your brother's disappearance.
Oh, dear Dorothy. She'd go looking for Bardolph herself if she could.
She mentioned dark magic and even the Ashwinders.
Despite my repeated warnings, Bardolph's been experimenting with dark magic near the edge of the forest. I thought perhaps he'd get it out of his system and it would gradually stop. But then one day, he didn't come home.
I'll let you know if I see or hear anything about him.
Thank you. How kind. I'd be so grateful to learn where he is. I know in my heart he's out there. Do be careful.
What do you have for sale?
Bardolph, where are you? I'll not give up hope. Thank you for passing through. Unpredictable and violent.
Revelio. Revelio. Past the river, near the forest. I must be on the right track.
Bring them! Take them! Incendio!
woolen jumper. I'm not sure Madame Beaumont would want to know what really happened to him.
Revelio. An entry from Bardolph's journal. He overheard whispers, a plan, something to do with him. This mentions in theory. And something about it being Bardolph's turn next.
See if there's something you need.
Oh, sheesh. It sucks.
That's been a pleasure.
See what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
What?
Renrod's vision of goblins ruling over wizards will be. See if there's something you need. Thank you for your patronage. That's been a pleasure.
Revelio.
What the hell?
Incendio! Rebellion.
nice of you to stop by. You will regret coming here. Those goblins in my family worked in the mines at one time or other.
One of Ranrock's camps. Exactly as Madame Beaumont described.
Wizards are running scared, as they should be.
Coming back this way.
Damn it.
Might I remind everyone that a wizard's sharpest tool is his mind. Perhaps best to shun that which leads it astray. An intruder!
You will regret coming here.
Oops.
kidding me?
That was unexpected.
I won't rest until you're dead.
Why can't I hit you?
I will make you.
How is this happening?
Your blood's on Vanrock's hands. One countdown, one more to go. Revelio.
Oh, come on.
Incendio. Rebellion.
Oh, there it is.
That wasn't too hard.
See if there's something you need. Thank you for your patronage. That's been a pleasure.
Such arrogance.
Madame Beaumont will be glad to hear that. Revelio.
I do miss the bustle of business. Poor customers, afraid to venture out.
Hello, Madame Beaumont. Good news. I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps.
You cleared them out? How?
It was harrowing, and they dug in their heels, but I managed.
When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ranrock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen.
I should be going now. Thank you.
What do you look? Thank you. Sincerely. Marvelous. I could always use more of thee.
Thank you for passing through.
Madame Beaumont, I do have some news of your brother.
Oh, please tell me he's safe.
I'm afraid he's joined the Ashwinders and has no interest in returning.
What? No, no, this can't be. He was seeking their advice, that's all.
I'm truly sorry. I wish it had been better news. I wish you well, Madame Beaumont.
What more I have done. Oh, Bardolph! Bardolph, my dear, dear brother.
I could use some gold.
Oh, sheesh. Quiet rascal. What's that?
Wonderful to see you again.
I've completed my assignments, Professor.
Pleased to hear it. Professor Weasley will be too. I'll be sure to let her know how well you're coming along.
Thank you, Professor.
Professor Hecate tells me she taught you Levioso, so you should be ready for a more advanced levitation charm. Wingardium Leviosa requires a bit of concentration and a nice, graceful wand movement. Let's see you try your hand at it. When executed correctly, you should be able to pick up boulders as though they were sprigs of snakeswort. Well done! Feel free to practice Wingardium Leviosa here in the greenhouse. I've set some crates out for you in the next room.
Body,
and guard the Leviosa.
You're back. Nice to see you again. What are we looking for today? Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Ravenia.
Velio.
To pursue anything I wanted. Good brain. That's what the teachers would say.
Whatever my task, I console myself knowing that...